They're not bad over the jumps, but they are so much fun on the pavement, just sliding around, rear wheel drive.
Well, here we go, in for a banger of a final. Front row, Riku Hukop and Pasi Pentanen. You then got Ronald Bowdins with that broken elbow, remember. Needs an operation on that next week. Isaac Egensen, Ekmerstad and Gustafsson. And bringing up the rear, Frieder Enholm and Sebastian Enholm. What do you think about Bowdins, Travis? His doctor told him, you've got to have an operation on your elbow. If you do it this week, you can't race. If you do it next week, you can. He's here racing.
Well, that's a racer.
There you go.
The doctor gives you an option. There's no choice.
you're talking to Travis Estrada. I don't know if you knew that.
Okay. I love it.
Yeah.
I love it.
This is good. This has been some of the best racing. I just love that everyone just gets sideways, and you watch, everyone's trying to get down on that first turn because it's so slick if you get outside the main line, but somehow these cross cars, they don't weigh much, so it doesn't affect them quite as much when they get out of the line.
All right, so eight cars. This is the finals, and again, double header. So both today and tomorrow, independent podiums, independent finishes. And there can be only one winner here today. Cross car final. You can see they're in that cockpit. And again, Smash, our FPV pilot, doing a great job getting all up close and personal. That's obviously the boom cam, but we're talking about getting in the car. Those cockpits so tight, so right, and just obviously just a lot of fun.
Yeah, the Hot Wheels car all at Lytton Hill was wheeling every time. It's a little bit slicker here on the takeoff, so we'll see if they're still able to get that traction they were the last event.
Yeah, we're trying to dial that out. You had the same problem last weekend, Travis, here. You're getting wheelies off the line, and then you have to back out of it, of course, to get the nose down. So they've actually softened it up, which I thought was the opposite of what they would do, but you said on these cross cars it goes the other way. Plus, they've taken 40 kilos off the back of these cars for the NRX regs, meaning they're faster and lighter for us, but different for these drivers than they're normally used to.
All right, here we go. You can see the countdown to race, and the finals are about to kick off. This should be interesting, and you were talking about bracket battles and what's going on. So now with eight cars, it could get pretty violent there into turn one, and with the exposed wheels, that changes things up quite a bit versus a full sports car. Nitro, and here we go. Let's send it for our cross car finals. Here we go, all of them. A great launch for all of them. Nobody popping wheelies here. Going to this first corner. Who's going to get the jump? Who's going to get the whole shot? And it looks like Hukop is out front.
Coming in wide.
Big angle.
Making it work. These carts are so light, they are able to make that work when they get a little bit outside. I can't believe these guys and girls are able to get so aggressive with the open wheel racing. Oh, there we go.
Spin in the background.
The 199's backwards. Why is that always the case?
It's the number. Bowdins has got up into P2 off the start, so come from the outside of row two. Managed to slot up into second place. There he is. P3 is Pasi Pentanen. And then I think it's Ekmerstad, Sebastian Enholm. Doing pretty well over the jump, aren't they? It's pretty rough sometimes.
Dude, Enholm was full on Tokyo Drift Ken Block style. Man, that never even lifted. That was awesome.
So good through this long right-hander. This is so challenging for these guys to hold onto the car, get the rotation in it, then try and flick it back the other way and then find traction. Remember, only rear-wheel drive at 9,000, 10,000 RPM, screaming it down the straight. I love watching them.
Absolutely. Really, really excited. I think we need to introduce the gap jump to them.
No, they could definitely do it. Our biggest thing, and half the drivers want to, half the guys don't. All the team owners say absolutely not. We have to prove that we can get them out of Europe, and then we'll get back to the U.S. We'll start introducing these guys like one class at a time until, you know, everyone's jumping.
Right.
Well, you know, Jim York will be jumping in the Van Prix, so we'll be all right.
Yeah, that'll be great. Yeah. Yeah, just this season has. I'm looking forward to going back to North America. Obviously, a little closer for me. Sorry, Cole, you got to do some travel.
I can live with it. It was great fun last year. I'm just excited. I've had a brilliant time, obviously, in Europe. It's been lovely for me to see this brilliant series come to Europe and where people can actually come and see it face to face. But the big jumps last year, Travis, ERX, I can't wait to see what the FC1 can do at those places when you can stretch their legs a little bit more.
You can stretch your legs, and they have so much power, it raises the front up. But look at this. So, I mean, Hukop has been doing absolutely amazing. Then you got Bowdins elected to take the Joker this lap. I think that's going to be a good plan. If Hukop thinks they got a little bit more lead, I mean, he was kind of tightened up. And if you're going to get surgery, you might as well go ahead and go out in style. He needs a win here.
See, there we go. It was the carnage in turn two that's given him the opportunity to do that. The rest of the field lost that time when there was the spin in the background. It was Gustafsson. It was facing the wrong way in the 199. So that gave Bowdins a chance to go early.
Wow.
The gap at the minute is 4.1.
Absolutely flying. Hukop is ripping and really boosted that tabletop. That's a big hit for them.
Zero mechanical sympathy for the Hot Wheels car out front. I love watching him drive.
Right. Oh, look at that. So we that's an interesting approach. I mean, you're a spotter, Coley, so tell us, is that the right approach?
He doesn't want to do it late in the race. Either that or he's concerned about the person behind closing him down. He's got out well in front, Jared, so Enholm went in as well and comes out behind. So that's just covering off Bowdens. Sometimes, yeah, don't leak. If the pressure's going to build towards the end of the race, you want to get it done early, that's fine. He's comfortable. He's got 1.9. Now he can actually see the car in his mirrors. Sometimes when the joker gap is in there and you don't know where that other car is, it starts to freak you out a bit. So, will they close me down or not?
Well, your spotter's going to be basically telling you, do I have enough time to take the joker and come on ahead? If I do, I don't care if I'm faster or slower. I'm going to take it right now, so then I'm going to make these guys pass me. But look, he is just launching that thing to flat everywhere. Does not care. Full sideways. Definitely by far my favorite driver to watch here. And if you look at Enholm, started out back row all the way up to third. That's amazing.
We had a medal last year in the Rally X Series called the Full Send Medal, and he was the first person we gave it to because he was so sideways everywhere he came. A lot of the categories, it doesn't work, it's not fast, but in cross car, you can make it work.
Watch him come into this first turn. If they show that corner, he's the only one stepping in wide.
Sorry, real quick, that back left, it looks a little low.
No, I think it's actually something
just rolling.
Broken. he's been, no mechanical sympathy, but you know what? He's only got a lap and a half to go, he'll be fine.
Yeah, just do it. That's where the rally comes in, right?
Until the wheels fall off. I love watching him.
Shout out for Sebastian Enholm in P3. Was on P8 on the grid, Jared, on the outside of the back row, and he's in third place. It's a great drive. Avoided all the trouble up in turn two on lap one. Right up there. Still got another lap to go. Only Gustafsson remaining to Joker.
Yeah, Huka, I think he was just rolling the tire, so it looks a little deflated. But absolutely sending it. Really well done by Huka. And Bowdens again with that Swolbo, you know, is sitting in second and home in third. And it looks like Huka from start to finish is going to get it, you know, but we still got that one lap left to go. But all signs are saying if the car stays together, Huka's got it. Really well done.
They're just so much fun. I mean, bang for your buck. I mean, this is great. We definitely have to start introducing these in the U.S. And you see a lot of the younger drivers, a lot of the people, they're a little bit more skittish to get in some of the bigger cars. But you can get in this, and you can pretty much drive on a motocross track.
They're allowed to drive here from 11 years old. So in the year that they're 12, they can race. There's a category called
cross-car. And that's why there's not an American in the final. We're bringing these to the USA. We're coming back, baby.
We're going to bring Nitro Junior is what we need now, isn't it? Like, we need to get the kids in. Yeah,
should that be a thing?
Back
yes.
Left.
Oh, it's... Lost a tyre, so that's Passy Penton. Lost a tyre, dropped back, dropped out to P8 now. In fact, it's been lapped by Huka, his teammate.
Yeah, no, that's unfortunate here, but Huka going for the final. Oh, look at this! We got a bunch up for second place! So is Baldwin's going to hold on to it, and home. These guys get into it, but Huka does get the win. What happened there?
Last
turn.
Place to second!
Bowden's caught Pentonen. Bowden's caught Pentonen with the puncture in the last corner.
Oh,
so he dropped
from
P2. I'm gutted for Ronalds. I think he's had contact in the last corner with Pentonen. That's a shocker for him. It's unusual to lap anyone in Rallycross, you know, and Passy was probably there. Ronalds didn't realize, but he still gets third.
All right. So still holds on to it. Riku, Huka, Sebastian Enholm gets second, and Bowden's with that broken elbow holds on to it. So a little bit of pride there. So congratulations to Huka getting the win here. Cross car final, day one.